Hey guys, I'm Tara with Tara Simon Studios, and I'm going to be reacting to David Phelps and his most resonant high notes. This is by a request from a lot of you guys, so thank you so much for the suggestion. I'm just going to dive right in and let you know what I think. And I believe, right from what I'm seeing as far as the still picture, that it's live performances, but if there are any studio recordings, I'll make note of that too as we go on. Very nice open mouth. You can see all the way back to the back of his throat. Beautiful harmony there. Really great control over straight tone into vibrato on that last note. Really great breath control to be able to hold a note like that long. Very nice. All these, by the way, are G4. That's why you see that. And then he moved up to G sharp 4. Can't see him here. It's just black. I like this placement a lot on this one because there's a little more lift in his cheekbones on this one. Sometimes it has a lot to do with the word that you're singing too. Great technique. That's an A. Very nice. So in order to hit these high notes, and by the way, they're not just one high note. It's either a really long high note that he's hitting or a compilation of a bunch of high notes in one melodic line. You have to have really good technique. You have to have open space. You have to be supporting with your abs. Remember the rule, if you've watched my videos before, any extreme note, high or low, needs space and support. And from what I'm seeing and hearing, he's giving exactly that, both of those things. That's a hard note to hit on an E because there's not a lot of space. You have to say, me, open up to find that space, even on that E. Ahs are much easier. Very nice. Nice. Good vocal flexibility in the riff. Beautiful, nice, relaxed vibrato, but not too slow to where it sounds like a tremolo. That's mix. Beautifully placed, too. That in a man is really difficult because it's a very teetery place to be in your voice. You're not quite sure if it's going to stick there or not. So he found that place, he locked it in, and he stuck it, and he just held it until the end of the note. That was really nicely executed. B flat 4 we're up to now. So part of the reason why he's able to hold that so long, we're not counting the great technique, right? This is just being smart about a note. Vibrato takes, I like to say, about 60% more breath than singing straight tone. I haven't actually measured that, but it feels like that to me when I sing, right? So when you sing with vibrato from the very beginning of your note, you're not able to hold it nearly as long if you continue that vibrato to the end of the note as if you started the note in straight tone and then moved into vibrato to end the note. So he does a really good job at starting in straight tone, holding the pitch beautifully, rationing off the breath, and then towards the end, like about three quarters of the way through to where he's finishing the note, that's when he starts to let go and give the vibrato, which, yes, takes more breath, but it also ties a beautiful bow on the package of the note, so to speak, to present a really nice ending. It's really nice. Very smart. Straight. Vibrato. You, yes. Now he did get to go to a nice ah at the top, and he started on vibrato. And here's one of the reasons that he could have possibly done that. When you go that far, when you're going from a huge jump from a 1 to an 8, you have to use a lot of ab support to make that jump happen on pitch, technically sound, and so that you can hold it. And sometimes you're using so much support that vibrato just happens, and that's okay. Get up to that note by any means and hold it. You can worry about straight tone later if you want to. I'm not hating that he did vibrato there at all. It was a great execution of a note. Yes. Straight tone. But notice, he didn't have such a far way to go that time. That time he chose to do vibrato, but he also took a breath right before the last note. Same thing here too, he took a quick breath before that last note. Huge ending. The guy back in the back, he's looking at him like, oh my gosh, that's funny. You see him? That's great. Sharp 5. Dang. And he's just sticking it. He's just letting time go by, looking at his watch. So you notice how he's kind of bending down like that? I do that too. When you really need to focus and use your whole body, because singing is a sport, right? When you're singing, it's a full body sport. It is not right here, right? And it is so impressive to me how he's using his whole body. When you're done singing notes like that, you should be sweaty. Your heart should be pounding. You should be out of stinking breath. You should need a nap, okay? I need a nap just listening to this man. And when he's bending down like that, I mean, you should have what I call capturable moments when you're a big singer. And capturable moments are, if I'm gonna take a photo of you, a still shot, when you're singing big notes, what do you look like? It better not be like this, because I guarantee you that note wasn't good. You gotta be like that, right? You gotta use your legs, you gotta use your hands, you gotta use whatever you can to create support everywhere else but here. Tension everywhere else but here. He does a great job of that. Yes, look at that mouth. Love this song. Look at that. Yes. Oh, gorgeous. The guy behind the desk. See how he bent? You see the camera following him? I hear classical training in David Phelps, of course. You know, he's really got that legit vocal production quality that's so nice. So high. D, we're at D now. Crazy. We started at G, just for those of you who have forgotten by now. That's like a mix, okay? That's so high that now his chest is naturally zipping up, which is great. E flat five. Yes, so that's E5. That's definitely mix. It's no longer fully belty anymore. It's just too high. The voice naturally zips up. Beautiful dissonance in that harmony. Yeah, whew, I'm into that for sure. Dang, okay, so he's excellent. He's really, really talented. Beautiful training, pristine voice, pristine vocal production, and he's very intentional about how he handles his notes. You can see great open mouth quality, you can see great support. He is a guy who knows what a note takes and he knows how to give the note what it needs, clearly. That is evident in how long he's able to hold the note, it's evident in his vocal timbre and quality, and it's also evident in the height of the notes that he's able to produce. Thank you so much for letting me watch this, guys, during a reaction. This was a real treat for me to see someone produce notes so beautifully, so technically sound, and so gracefully. That's vocal health at its finest right there. So that was awesome. Thank you, David Phelps. You rock my world. And if you like what you saw, please subscribe below. If you need any lessons yourself, you want to try to sound like David, I am happy to help, or my coaches are happy to help. You can click the link below for that. And you can also sign up for an 8-week course that I'm doing. It's the fundamental level of what my methodology is called Sing Smarter, Not Harder. And it gives you a nice broad brush and an in-depth study at your own pace on what that means. So click there if you want to sign up for that. And as always, please leave more comments in the box below to give me some more reaction suggestions, because I am happy to review those. And if you just want to say hi, I'm here. I read all the comments. So please make sure to give me a shout out and let me know what you think about the videos. I'll see you guys on the next one.